Captive. Good news for the shame. There is good news for the world who walked away. There is good news for the doubter. The one religion failed. For the good Lord has come to seek and save. He's our rescuer. He's our rescuer.
Tomorrow brings. With each morning I'll rise. While my heart is beating, while my body's breathing, my future's there for you to write. Though today I'm hurting, there's a new day coming, bright and shining like your smile. I won't give up, no, no, I won't give in, no, no, you are the tide on which I rise. I won't back up, no, no, I won't back down, no, no, this is the time for me to rise. You are the fun in my life, you are the joy.
Riches for the poor. He is friendship for the shameless. Come and be fearless. Come to the foot of Calvary. There is redemption for every affliction.
Troubled sea, whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea, whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore. Love will lead me through. You are the peace.
Good morning, welcome to our Good Friday family worship. Normally we would be meeting together to have our Good Friday messy church special in the school, but of course we can't do that. But we can still worship together and reflect on the events of Good Friday. Today we're going to have a couple of craft activities for you to get involved with, and we're going to sing together, and we're going to think about why we call this day Good Friday. Before we do any of that, I thought I might just tell you the Good Friday story from this Bible. This was one of my children's christening Bibles. He's 16 now, but it's been a well-loved and well-used book. And the story here starts where we started last night, with Maundy Thursday, with Jesus gathering with his disciples for that special meal that he left with them, the Last Supper. And it says this: a few days later, Jesus met with his friends to eat the festival meal. He warned them of hard times ahead. He told them always to love one another. He shared bread and wine with them. And he told them always to share bread and wine and to remember him in this special way. Then Jesus went out to a quiet place to pray. Father God, he said, I don't want these hard times, but I will do what you want. Already one of Jesus's friends had joined the plan to get rid of Jesus. In fact, we can see him on the last page, just sneaking out of the Last Supper to go and find the soldiers. He came with the soldiers who took Jesus away. The next day, Jesus was put to death, nailed to a cross of wood. In the evening, a few friends came and took the body to a tomb. We must say goodbye, said one. The sky was getting dark. This must be the end of Jesus making the world a better place. They wept. So that all sounds very sad, doesn't it? But we call this day Good Friday. I'm going to explain a little bit more about that later on. But first of all, we're going to sing, and we're going to sing together that song called Servant King. So please join together with this song.
To bring our lives as a the scars that speak of sacrifice, hands that flung stars into space, to cruel nails surrender. This is our God, the servant king. He calls us now to fall.
Ellel is now going to show us a couple of craft activities that you could get involved with making at home. First of all, she's going to show you how to make a cross out of simple things that you can find in the garden or around your house. And then she's going to show you how to make an Easter garden. So over to Helen, and we look forward to what she brings for us. Thank you.
Hello. The church has asked us, as a sign of solidarity, to put crosses in our windows this Sunday. So we might have a palm cross, but equally we might have lots of twigs around the fields and gardens left over from the storms in February that we could use to make our own crosses. I've made this very simple one with some of the kindling out of my fire supply. I've just lashed it around, and I'll show you how to do that now. So you need two twigs. Got two there, not too bad. One's got a knobble on the end. I could chop that off, but I haven't got my secateurs here. So, two twigs and some cord, some string, some thread, some wool, whatever you've got handy. I'm going to make two loops in the end. One. Two. I'm going to put the second one under the first one and thread those onto the crossbar. It's a little bit rough, this crossbar, but remember that Jesus was crucified on just a piece of plank. It wouldn't be a neatly planed piece of wood. It was just a branch off a tree. So we've got our starter on one side. Then if we take it across diagonally on the back and round the back of that one, you see that, and then across diagonally on the front and whoopsie-daisy around the back of that one, and then over, across, over, across, and tie the ends together. Takes me back to my guiding days 50 years ago lashing two pieces of wood together. Tie those into a nice, neat knot. You might like to edit this out. If you notice, my tongue comes out every time I'm concentrating. And trim off the end. Okay, it's not quite in the middle, so you can probably just edge it a little bit. And there we have it. A cross representing all that Christ did for us. And reminding us that even in these dark times, God is there with us, bringing good out of the darkness. And he will never leave us, just as he never left Jesus on the cross. So I'll put one of these crosses into my window this weekend. I hope you'll put yours in too. And do upload them onto the website so we can see the windows with the crosses in them. Perhaps you'd like to make three, like Golgotha. Thank you. Hello. I'm going to do something this morning that I've done since I was a very little girl on Good Friday morning, and that's to make an Easter garden. We used to make a big one in church with vases of daffodils and willow, catkins, pussy willow. But today I'm making a small one, and I wonder if you'd like to make one as well at home. So I've got a big green tray, a bit like the ones you use at school for your books. But I've covered it with papier-mâché at one end to build a mountain. So I made my papier-mâché with lots of strips of newspaper and some flour and water paste. A cup of flour for a cup of water. Makes a nice gloopy paste, and then you can stick the strips over the top. And I've started to paint it with brown and green, and you can see there I've got a hollow for the tomb. And I've got a stone somewhere to put across that tomb, as they did on Good Friday, to seal up the tomb. So I'm just going to put the last little touches of paint to it. I found some paints left over from some modelling, so just dabbing on the paint over the top. I've got some green areas on the mountain. It would have been a very rocky mountain, so a very brown mountain. There we are, that will do. I made this papier-mâché yesterday and left it then to dry, so it's had lots of time to dry itself off. You can't paint it until it is dry, or it goes all soggy and makes a mess. There. One mountain. On the top of our mountain, outside Jerusalem, was the spot where Jesus was crucified. So I've made a hole in there, and I've put in one cross. Could put two more in for the two thieves if you want to, but I'm just putting one for the time being. And then I'm going to fill this messy space here, which you can see is a bit mucky from the moss that I've had in it. I'm going to turn this into a pretty garden. So I've been round my garden and looked for some odd leaves and little bits of twigs. I've got some moss here that I've pulled off the stones. So I'm going to put the moss down as though it was the lawn or the grass. Not sure the sort of garden that Jesus was buried in was had a lawn. It would have had rough grass and lots of rocks amongst the grass. So here we've got some rocks that I've picked up as well. There are the rocks alongside.
a little bit more moss. Picked this moss yesterday and soaked it in water overnight so that it's... Well, some of it's a bit too wet really, but there we are. And if you wanted to, you could put some kitchen towel down in the bottom and just dampen it and then put the moss on top of that. There, I've got moss into my tray now, all the way along, and some of the rocks. I've pulled up a little plant here. I call it a weed in the garden, but it's a pretty little leaf. So we'll put that along the front, trailing leaf. And here, some tiny petals that have come off, and even some ordinary daisies put into there. And this bush smells nice as well, so that makes a nice smell. Might be able to put something else into there in a minute just to fill it up. And I found as many little containers as I can that are tiny enough to be hidden by the moss or the stones in here, and will hold these little flowers. Everybody knows what these are, and we usually call these a weed, but look how beautiful they are. We've got time at the moment to enjoy our flowers. So put it down to size and pop the dandelion in there. Here's another dandelion. It's one way of making sure that they don't turn into dandelion. We call them the fly away. And got some celandines as well. Strange, isn't it, that so many of our spring flowers are yellow. Yellow cheers us up. And although on Good Friday, when Jesus' body was put into the tomb, it was a sad day and the world was dark, on Easter Sunday, when we'll be able to remove the stone, we'll be able to enjoy these flowers and the life and the cheerfulness that they bring. Here I've cut some leaves off some bigger plants to pretend they're trees. So we'll have a tree at the back, an aquilegia tree. Cut it down a little bit so it'll topple out. Won't stay there, might just. Here's another selection of flowers. Another little shot glass. Let's put that one right over here. It's a good idea to stand them on the firm base. Now, if you haven't got a tray this size, then anything would do. You can just use the petals and just put the petals or the flowers into the moss. It's very tiny. So maybe if you haven't got a big tray, you could use an ice cream tub or a meat tray. Something that is hanging around and you're recycling. That's ideal for this job. To put that rest of that purple one into there. What else have I got? I've got a little jam jar there, some flowers in, we'll nestle that at the front. And then I've got a big foresty one, put that next to the dandelions at the back. How does that look? You can see better than I can. Now, if you haven't got any rocks hanging around, although most of us can find some on our walks around here, you can always decorate an egg. This is the egg that I used for making a cake yesterday. So put that in as a rock. Paint it if you want. And I'm going to put a shell in as well, because Easter's a time when we remember the new life. New life in Jesus, new life in our spring flowers, new life in our eggs, and new life in baptism. And the shell is a symbol of baptism. It's It's what Craig often uses to pour water over the baby's head. So I'm going to put a shell in there. And I also thought I could make some people. Now, it's going to be a bit crowded in my Easter garden, but I was looking around for what to make people out of. Here's a yoghurt pot, an Actimel pot, and I'm just going to put a little bit of my glue on. I started doing this. I haven't got all the people now on Blue Peter to say, here's one I made earlier. This is one I started earlier. So I'm just dressing this person in blue, and I'm going to imagine that it is Mary Magdalene. There she is, she's got a blue dress on, and I've got a little bit of pale blue here for her headscarf, and maybe then she'll need to have a face drawn on her as well. I'm not very good at drawing faces, I'll leave you to do that. There she is, Mary Magdalene, looking in the garden for Jesus. If you haven't got a bottle like that, then you could use a peg. Don't look too closely at that face. I think that's John or Peter running to look in the empty tomb. But that's an ordinary clippy peg, as it stands up nicely. Would do. So, what haven't we got? Anything? Ah, I know what we haven't got. When the stone is rolled away on Easter, inside there's no body. But what they do find are the robes that Jesus was wrapped in. So, I've got some white material here. I'm just going to put a strip of white material and put that into the tomb as a sign that there's no body there now, just the dead clothes from the dead body, and then seal it up again. And there we have our Easter garden. I'm sure you can make one as well, and we'd love to see them. So if you've got time today or tomorrow to go around and find some bits out of your garden, make a nice Easter garden, then put a picture onto the Facebook page and we'll show them, share them around. Thank you very much. Bye bye.
We've explored the theme of Good Friday today by looking at the Bible story, by singing together, and by sharing with you a couple of craft activities that you can have a go at home. Right at the beginning, I asked us why we call today Good Friday. Well, the Bible explains it like this. It says that we've all done something wrong. We've all sinned, as the Bible calls it, and fallen short of God's expectations. But if we acknowledge our sin, if we say sorry to God for the things that we've done wrong, that God will forgive us. And I want to show you a quick illustration about that. So I have here a little egg. This is not a hard-boiled egg, it's a delicate fresh egg. And I've drawn a picture of me on it and written the word me to represent me. I think it looks a little bit like me. In fact, I'm sure there's some of you out there who's thinking, actually, I think it looks a lot like you, Craig. But this represents me. And I can certainly think of times when I've done things wrong, and I'm sure you can as well. And the Bible says, as I've said, that the payment for those things that we do wrong is death. That we deserve to die because of those things that we do wrong. But God is faithful, and he forgives us our sins. And he does that with the events of Good Friday. See, when Jesus died on the cross, he took away all of our sin and all the things that we have done wrong and all the things that we will ever do wrong. And what we need to do is to say sorry to him, take them to the cross and be forgiven. You'll know what would happen if I brought my fist down onto the top of this egg. It would splatter all over my coffee table and I would be in trouble. But what happened on Good Friday was that Jesus, if you can see this can, represents Jesus. I've drawn a cross on it and written the word Jesus on it. See, Jesus covers over us and covers over all the things that we do wrong. And instead of us being splattered, he's the one that gets splattered and takes the punishment for all the wrong things that we have done and all the things that we will ever do. And so on this Good Friday, we can, like my little egg, smile and celebrate because we know what it is to receive God's forgiveness, to know what it is to have our sins, the things that we do wrong, taken away. So I'm just going to pray, thanking Jesus for Good Friday. So let us pray together. Lord Jesus, we thank you on Good Friday that you took all the things that we have ever done and all the things that we will ever do to the cross. And there you achieved forgiveness for us. We thank you that whenever we hurt others or we hurt you, whenever others hurt us, we can come to the cross and receive your forgiveness and offer that forgiveness to other people. We thank you for what you achieved on this day. Thank you that we can call this Good Friday. In your name we pray. Amen. And just before we go, I'd like to invite you to gather again on Easter Sunday. We've got our Easter Sunday service in the morning, which will be a communion service and a little bit of reflection for children as well in there. That will be broadcast at 10:30 on Easter Sunday morning. And then on Easter Sunday afternoon, from 3 o'clock, we'll be broadcasting another little worship session like we've had today, but on Easter Sunday. So please do join us for some of those things. Great to see you again. Thank you very much for tuning in.